With frame-by-frame editing capabilities in KineMaster, synchronizing multiple cameras is super easy, which is great news if you like to film live performances, because with two cameras, you can record one with wide settings and hold a second one to grab some nice close-ups as the action unfolds. Hey guys, it's Paddy, and today I'm going to show you how to sync and edit a two-camera shoot of Australian musical legend Dusty Starr. The files I'm going to use today are linked below in the show notes, so download those and edit along with me as I explain the process. The first thing we need to do is get our media. So we select media, click on the album Dusty Starr, and then we're going to select this track here, which is our A camera, and this track here, which is our B camera, and we'll click here to exit. So now we've got two tracks, and in a moment I'll lay these up on top of each other, but before I do, I need to ensure they both have the same start position. Now I'm sure you've all seen clapperboards at the movies, but these will work just as well. So start your cameras rolling, and then get the person in front of the camera to clap, and let me show you why. So here we can see Dusty clapping his hands, which gives us a great visual reference for syncing, but for added accuracy, let's select the video track, extract the audio, and now you can see we also have an audio spike on the waveform we can reference. So the idea is, if we get someone to clap, then trim both of our clips to start at exactly the same moment, we can put them on top of each other and they will be in sync. So let's trim away this footage on the left by clicking this handy shortcut, like so. Now, don't worry about the audio we extracted, we can actually delete that, because I'll show you. If we click into our mixer, we can restore our audio simply by unclicking the mute button.
So that's a great feature of KineMaster. You can extract the audio temporarily from a track to get visual representation of the sound you're looking for in a clip, then delete it again because KineMaster simply mutes your connected audio. Let's do the same thing again to the footage from my second camera.
So there's his clap. Let's extract our audio, zoom in so we can really see, and let's position our playhead over this middle clap again. Select trim to the left of playhead, and delete the audio track. Now we're going to click these three little dots here, and duplicate as layer, which we will drag across to lay it over our other camera. Now, I'll delete this one here, and these cameras should now be in sync. Let's have a listen and see what we think.
Beautiful.
Okay, they do appear to be in sync, and the sound is coming from this first track, which is the one I had my microphone on, and the second track we'll leave on mute. Let's select the first track again, and select mixer, then auto volume to give our audio a little pop.
Ready to roll.
Place the playhead just before the music starts, and with track one selected, click trim split and split at playhead. Now do the same thing for track two. The reason being, we want to ensure we cut both tracks in exactly the same place so they remain in sync. Now we can resize track B to fill the screen, but I find it helps to keep it smaller for now so that we can see both cameras at once as we make our cuts and select our shots. Before we do that, let's click on Adjustment and add a little contrast and brightness to better match camera A. That looks pretty close, so let's watch the first little bit and see what we think. So, a nice mid-shot, slowly panning down to the guitar. I think this should be our first shot for sure. Now, at this point here, we want to notch out our B-roll to reveal track A so we can see our performer as he starts to sing. Click the track, trim split, split at playhead, then shuttle forward as I change my shot, and split it playhead again. Now we can delete this unwanted bit and we get a nice gap. Let's select this first clip, select split screen and click here to make this clip full size. Now we have our nice mid shot at the beginning, cut to our wide shot for a few moments, and then back to this close up of the fretboard. So I think you can see how with these two cameras in sync, it's very simple for us to notch out all the unwanted footage from camera B and then use our split screen settings to quickly resize the clips to full screen. To apply a transition to smooth out your cuts, select the track, click in animation, then apply the transition of your choice. Select the clip again, and now choose out animation, select your transition, and play the clip to see the effect. That's much better. To jazz things up even more, select a clip from your B-roll, select split screen, and you can split the screen into two parts just like this, which looks pretty cool. You can reposition which part of your clip shows, or adjust the width to get quite an interesting little effect. But I think we can do even better.
If I was filming a guitar tutorial, I think this would be the perfect setup. Wide shot to the left, close up to the right.
But I think I would like to see some separation between the shots, and that's easy to achieve. Click the layer, then select Media, Photo, Background, and apply a white background. We can resize it and click here to change the order. And now we have a nice white line delineating between the two shots. Drag out these handles so our background matches the clip duration. Perfect.
Finally, let's add a quick title.
Select layer. Choose text and type in our performer's name, Dusty Star. Now we can resize the title, change the position. We can also change the font. Let's select in animation, select fade, and we're done.
So there you have it, a two camera shoot synced, edited and finessed in around 10 minutes using KineMaster for iOS, iPadOS and Android. Sweet. My name's Paddy McCann and I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If so, be sure to subscribe right here on the KineMaster channel and feel free to look me up on YouTube for some more great tips on mobile content creation. I'll catch you next time.